Hey man, you're watching the Daily Brew right here on PTN.
Good morning, coffee drinkers and news seekers, and welcome to a Tuesday edition of the Daily Brew, where we're drinking our favorite coffee and reading the headlines. Our top story: Dow sinks 300 plus points. U.S. stocks were hammered on Monday, with benchmark indexes falling through key support levels after a gauge of factory activity disappointed. Heightened concerns about the economy before Friday's monthly jobs report. Yeah, they're just having a hard time on Wall Street. Maybe it has to do with the Fed easing, as they say, the quantitative easing. In a related story, stocks fall and worst January in years. Yep, that's, Ben Bernanke's getting out just at the right time, isn't he, folks? Because the stocks are falling, because the Fed is, not giving them any more welfare. So you're going to see these companies probably sell off a whole bunch, and these, stockholders sell off a whole bunch so they can get their profits now before the whole damn thing collapses. And then they can be, nice and secure because they've been, getting this welfare and making a bunch of money off the American taxpayer, while the rest of us will probably be left to suffer. In other news, mass sea star death off U.S. West Coast puzzling scientists. Starfish have been mysteriously dying by the millions in recent months along the U.S. West Coast. Worrying biologists who say these sea creatures are key to the marine ecosystem. Scientists first started noticing the mass deaths in June 2013. Different types of starfish, also known as sea stars, were affected, from wild ones along the coast to those in captivity. The most commonly observed symptoms are white lesions on the arms of the sea stars. The lesions spread rapidly, resulting in the loss of the arms. Within days, the infection consumes the creature's entire body and it dies. Entire populations have been wiped out in the Puget Sound off the coast of Washington State, in the Salish Sea off Canada's British Columbia, as well as along the coast of California. The mortality rate is estimated at 90%, and the scientists and biologists have no clue why it's happening. Here's an idea, you scientists and you biologists out there. Maybe it's radiation? Maybe? Just possible? Just a few years back, there was that thing called Fukushima. Do you guys remember that? And all that radioactivity got spread into the water? Is it possible that now that it's kind of hitting the West Coast, that it's taking out the, sea stars? Hey, what do I know? I'm just a little guy. I might be totally crazy. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, Pentagon intelligence officer says Chinese hypersonic weapon poses major challenge. Chinese new hypersonic maneuvering warhead is a great, great concern because it appears designed for the use with both nuclear and conventional Chinese military forces. Nice. The ultra high speeds make the maneuverability of these missiles difficult to counter with missile defense interceptors. So let's see, last week we were deploying, blimps off Washington because we were worried about ballistic missiles flying in, and now we're worried about these hypersonic missiles from China. Does it sound like maybe something might be going down soon? Maybe, I don't know. Again, I might just be crazy. Hey, I am one of those conspiracy nuts, and I don't know what's going on out there, right? So anyways, ladies and gentlemen, what can I say? That's it for the Daily Brew. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like it and share it and thumbs it up and put it on Twitter and put it on Facebook. Share the information if you think it's relevant and if you enjoy the Daily Brew. Hey, we need to get this information out to everyone. And until tomorrow, which is hump day, this is John the Bang, and I'll see you later. Have a good night. Bye.